In most places in the world, when people think about going to hospitals or getting medical supplies there,
it's not a big problem.
You can just get in a car. In Rwanda, it's a little bit different. With using a drone, you don't have to worry about whether the roads are slippery today, whether it's nighttime or daytime. My name is Joseph Ndagijimana. I am the general manager for Zipline Rwanda. Zipline is a drone delivery service. We deliver blood, medical products, vaccines to hospitals in remote areas in Rwanda and in Ghana. One of the hospitals we serve just requested us to send us 2 units of red blood cells. So Nicole over here is going to start packing it and make sure that the units get to the hospitals as soon as possible. The hospitals do not know when someone is going to come up at the hospital with a knee condition. So the pharmacist picks up the phone and calls Zipline. So within 5 minutes, the drone will be in the air going to the hospital. So we aim to make it as fast as possible.
Some of the products that Zipline delivers are needed in critical situations, like life or death situations.
When the blood dropped here, then this lady will just pick it and take it to the laboratory. It's coming, it's coming. it is like lightning. It is very fast. Zipline has done a lot to us. No matter has reduced the costs that we've been incurring in going to Kigali to collect the blood.
If there is a woman at the hospitals, they were going to deliver their baby, but then something unexpected happened and they started to bleed, you don't have the luxury to do a 4-hour drive one way and then 4 hours the other way to be able to treat that patient. We asked the hospitals, like, how long does it take to get supplies? And they were like, okay, 6 hours, sometimes a day when it has been raining. And we were like, okay, yes, we're going to beat that. When Zipline started developing this technology, Rwanda was one of the first countries that were interested. Many other countries were interested, but Rwanda was willing to take the risk. Rwanda is embracing innovation and technology. It's one of the competitive advantages over other places where there are many natural resources or like more access to trade. I have a drone coming back from a hospital that we are going to recover. So the structure has motors and they communicate with our server. And when the drone gets within the vicinity of the distribution center, they can already communicate. There is a small hook on the tail of the drone that the recovery system is gonna catch. Here we go. The recovery system communicates with great precision with the drone to be able to catch it mid-air. It's small continuous improvements that we do that make a big difference. The doors on the drones that are kept here standby, even the doors are open, so you don't want to even waste those fractions of seconds.
Zipline Muhanga is the busiest airport in Rwanda. It's busier than Kigali International Airport. On a day-to-day basis, we can do around 30 deliveries here, and then another 20 from our second distribution center in the eastern part of Rwanda. We are currently working with 44 hospitals, but we are working to also onboard more health facilities. So our goal is to be able to service all 500 health facilities in Rwanda using our 2 distribution centers. So our capacity is estimated to be around 150 deliveries a day.
Zipline works to give access to vital medical supplies to patients in rural areas. I think if we have been delivering pizzas to people's homes, we would have had a harder time like convincing the government to take a risk and like be the first country to actually have drone delivery service on a national scale.